Okay, so I wanted to start talking about search trees and backtracking using one of my favorite programming problems, which you probably also encountered in one of your earlier courses on programming, because it really is a very nice example of techniques. So the problem is that you have a chessboard. Chessboard is just 8x8 grid, and you have a queen. A queen can move. Queen is essentially the most valuable piece in the chessboard, except for the king. But in fact, the queen is much more powerful than the king. The king is just, you know, full of himself and doesn't do anything most of the time, except that when he dies, then the game is over. But otherwise, except for his ability to die, he doesn't contribute much. So a queen can move either on the row that she's on, the column that she's on, or she can move on the diagonals. Okay. So you can think about it as this is her area where she's dominating the board, right? Or an area of influence. Okay. So here is this drawn without the black-white for the chess board, just to make things clearer. And now, you know, if I put a second queen in, which is not in the area of influence of the first queen, then, you know, it has its own area of influence. And the question is essentially, I would like to put several queens that none of them are in the area of influence of some other queen, right? They're independent. They cannot, no queen can attack another queen that I put in. So the rule of the game is that, you know, I just mark all the cells that are under the influence of the first queen or the of other influence in the second queen, and I can now just pick a queen in any cell that is not marked, right? It's not being influenced by either queens. So here is a third queen. Here is a fourth queen here in the corner. And, you know, and now you can put another two queens, right? And we got a solution with six queens. And clearly you cannot do any better, right? All the pieces of the, all the location in the chessboard are, you know, influenced or under control of one of the queens, maybe under influence of several queens. Okay, so the eight queen problem asks, can you put eight queen of the board on the boards, right? And the answer, of course, is yes. Here is a solution. This is a unique solution because it's the only solution that is symmetric. And this is an interesting problem. It was suggested in 1848 and solved only in 1850. It's not that difficult. I think it can be solved by hand. You just need to be a bit patient. So I don't know why it took so long for it to be solved. Maybe because nobody really cared. Nowadays, you know, it's easily solvable by computer, but then you can ask the problem about what about bigger boards, right? Instead of n of equal 8, think about n equal to 40 or 100, right? So the problem becomes much more difficult to solve. So the standard way to solve this problem is recursively is as follows, right? We decide, you know, in the top level, we decide where to put the queen in the top level, right? So you can think about it as we have a root, and then we have eight possibilities for the location of the first queen. And hopefully this is eight. Then this is one, two, three, and so on. Then let's assume we decided on two. We put the queen in the second location. Then we have, again, every node has eight children. I don't know, this is four, right? So you put, this corresponds to putting the queen at location four. So in fact, we will call it 2-4, right? Because it's the two and four, right? So if you think about it, a solution is just a permutation, right? Because in every row you have to give a numbers between one and eight, and the numbers in all those eight rows needs to be unique. So really are, you can write this down, every node in this tree, you can write down the prefix of the permutation it encodes so far, right? Now, this is a recursive algorithm, right? The algorithm at the top level chooses the location of the first queen. In the second level, it tried to put a placement in the second row, and it tries only the possibility that they're valid, right? Such that the placement is not under threat by the first queen. Then it goes down and try the third one and so on. Of course, what happened at some point, it would get stuck because it's not the solution not possible. Then it would backtrack, right? It would just return to the original recursive call. And then the algorithm essentially is successful only when we got down to the eighth level and we got to a leaf, which encode a complete, permutation of 1 to 8, which is full and is valid. Of course, this is not going to be a valid solution, but I'm just writing it because it's easy to write down. Okay, so that's the basic procedure. And then you can see this is a recursive algorithm, right? Because at the ith level, we decide where to put the ith queen, and we carry with us the location of all the previous queen already placed when we check for whether or not it's valid to put the next queen. Right? So it's a simple recursive algorithm. The backtracking just happens where we return after we tried all possibilities and no possibilities are left, because that essentially means that we are done. And we output, for example, we can, for example, stop, in this case, since we're searching the whole tree, whenever we get to a leaf at level 8, we output the solution in code, and that would output all the possible solutions. If I remember correctly, for the 8x8 queen, there are 92 solutions. But I might be wrong, of course. So that's it, right? It's a simple recursive algorithm where there is backtracking going on. Here is the tree for the 5 n equal 5 case, right? So this is the beginning. This here corresponds to the algorithm decide to put the first row queen at location 3. Then, this is corresponding to putting, it goes down and put the queen in location 1. It doesn't have children for 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 3, 4, because those are all invalid configuration. And it goes down to 3, 5, right? And then continues down, right? And as you can see, in this case, the tree is pretty simple. The reason why I printed it for n equal 5 is because for bigger values of n, the tree becomes, too large to really see what's going on, right? And here in the bottom, we get all the valid solutions, right? So if you want, we can draw one of the example just to see that it's indeed a valid solution. Okay, so 2, let's take this one. 2, right? Put the queen here, put the queen at 5, put the queen at 1. Why did I say 1? Oops. 2, 5, 3, right? So 3, 1, and 4. Right? And this is clearly a valid solution. Okay? So this is how it works. Right? It's a simple algorithm. It's very cute. And the nice thing is that, especially nowadays, computers, it can be solved in a super fast, it's solved faster than you press the enter key. But it's a very clean problem. It's very easy to program. So that's nice. And here is, in fact, the code, right? This is the code taken from my own implementation. Old implementation, this is recursively, this is written in C or C++, I apologize. So we have the permutation, this is the array that contains all the location we already encountered. Row is the current row being filled, and N is the total number of rows. If the number of rows is N, then we just print the solution. Otherwise, we try all possible locations for a queen in the current row, right? If it's valid, then we put it into the table and we call recursive. Right? And that's it. And then the main procedure just calls, you know, if we want 8 queen, it calls on it like that. And that's it. Right? So it's a really very simple algorithm, and that's what we mean by backtracking, right? Now, in general, I should say that backtracking tends to be more complicated because backtracking is used when the search trees are usually monstrously large, right? So this tree, you know, it's not small for 8 queens, but it's not especially large. But when you think about a chess playing tree, right, you're trying all possibilities, you analyze what next move to do, you speculatively try to generate the next moves, right? The tree that you get is huge. It's not infinite, by the way, because in chess, if you repeat the configuration too many times, it's a draw, but it's the tree is monstrous, even for modern computers. So what chess programs do, they do state evaluation, right? They go down and they get to a board, and then they use some heuristic to score the board, and then they search for the best board in their subtree. So, you know, and to speed up things, they do things like rough estimation of the score instead of doing expensive estimation, and they go down only if you have to, and so on. So there are a lot of variants of this, and it's widely used in practice. You might, in a lot of places, this is referred to as a star search. But, you know, it's usually heuristic. Very rarely you can analyze really what's going on. So, you know, we will not speak about those things too much in this class, but it's useful to know about them because in practice, of course, they're extremely useful. And this is it.